television's most popular programs, The Late Late Breakfast Show. Now, you all know the tragic, terrible event that led to the ending of the series, and in my opinion, the brave and honest decision taken by my next guest to bow out. However, on Christmas morning, God and electricians permitting, he returns with a live show. So let's welcome him back on live television tonight, Noel Edmonds. Thank you. We're very glad to see you back. Then, obviously, we must talk about the terrible thing that happened. And what subsequently has been the public reaction from your point of view?
Overwhelming, in the true sense of that word. I mean, I think overwhelming is a word that's used an awful lot by a lot of different people, mainly sportsmen who say, "I was terribly overwhelmed about this, that, and the other." But obviously, I was aware there would be a tremendous reaction after the accident. And I wasn't quite sure how people would react. I mean, I was aware there would be the inevitable people who would write to Points of View and write to the BBC, and quite rightly treat it extremely seriously. But I wasn't quite sure how people would react to me. And I have been so grateful for the way in which people have written to me, in their thousands, at my home and at the BBC. They have written in a way which is just so nice and has given me so much strength. They've written two or three pages, sometimes telling me things like, I lost my husband under tragic conditions last year, and this, this, and this, and life goes on. Or maybe telling me about responsibilities they've had in their world and how doing what I felt was the honourable thing in saying, no more, I haven't got the heart for this, that this was also correct and they understood my position. And so many people actually writing and saying, I've never written to the BBC before, I've never written to a TV personality before, but I just had to. And I think looking at the letters, it was a theme that really came out of all of them. The tragic death of Michael Lush suddenly produced in people who maybe didn't even watch the show a necessity, first of all, to pass on sympathy to the family, but also to the production team as well. I think people realised that this was a terrible shock and it was a tragedy that came out of the blue. There wasn't an inevitability that this would ever happen. And the reasons why it happened hopefully will be revealed when the inquest is held.
Yes, of course it was a terrible tragedy for the family. We won't and can't and shouldn't diminish that. But a traumatic time for you recently as well, your career would seem to have stopped dead.
Yeah, if I'm croaking, it's because I've got scarlet fever.
Lucky Edmonds, they call it.
I've got a very sore throat at the moment, thanks to the little lady in my life, Charlotte, who's watching. Hello. And I won't tell you what she calls you, but it's out of affection.
Yeah.
And I've got a very sore throat, so I'm croaking around, but the spots have gone, thank goodness. It was a very strange feeling to suddenly go through the diary and literally snowpake everything out and just realise that, I suppose it was a feeling very similar to maybe how the captain of a ship feels when he's lost the vessel. I mean, suddenly something that involves a lot of my life, the Late Late Breakfast Show is something that you don't just turn up on a Saturday and do. There's a tremendous amount of work involved. And I'd had the opportunity to take something similar to America, and Australia had just bought the last series, and the show is going out in Australia at the moment.
What did they know in Australia?
No taste, no study. It just proves you can peddle that kind of thing anywhere in the world. And to suddenly, you know, bang, it's gone. Obviously, it was a tremendous shock. And the reaction of people has helped enormously. I mean, I've always felt I've been very lucky, like your good self. We enjoy a very special relationship with the public. And I was terrified that that relationship would end. So when I talked about quitting completely and getting out of public life, it was because I wasn't sure whether that very special relationship had been completely ruined.
Yeah, are you confident? You're probably not very confident, but are you happy now to try again?
Yes. And it has come out of the tremendous support that people have given me. I mean, it's the breadth of the letters is incredible. And if there's anybody who's ever thought from hearing a bit of news, oh, I shall write to that person, do, because I can honestly tell you it really does mean a lot, and I'm trying to reply to the letters. I've had to have a little card printed, but I'm writing tops and tails to them, and I won't get them all out before Christmas, but if you wrote to me, or even you thought of writing to me, thank you very much indeed, because it's meant a lot to me. It's meant a tremendous amount to Helen, and we had a bad couple of weeks.
And you'd only just married Helen, and yeah. It's a hell of an introduction to marriage, isn't it?
I got a Helen, because you seem to be getting on with a Helen, so I thought, well, I'll go for the Helen.
Good.
A well-tried,
good man.
Road-tested model, so I thought, I'll get one of those. And
and it hasn't broken down yet?
No, it started to produce another one.
Oh, good.
Which is amazing. Very good investment, actually. She really has gone in at the deep end, because we had a very public walking out, courtship and whatever. And the papers loved that, you know, because Charlotte was around. So, of course, that makes super copy. And then we got married, and it was a very romantic setting. And so that was good news. And now she's had to see me at my lowest and see some pretty awful things. I mean, in the week after the accident, somebody decided they wanted to threaten my life. So we had police protection. And we had nutters come to the house, and I mean that in the true sense of the word, nutters. I mean, very unpleasant people who just simply want to feed off someone else's difficulties. And so the gardener was armed with a pitchfork and laid about anyone that moved. And this is all a bit worrying. And it's a mark of a relationship, and it's a relationship for which I'm truly grateful.
You didn't feel at any stage, I don't think I can handle it here anymore, I'm going to up stakes and go to America or Australia?
No, that would have been an easy way out. I must admit, I really did think, particularly when we had problems, I mean, when you've got police dogs around the grounds and they're looking at the Great Danes and thinking, oh, that's a pretty Great Dane, and all that's going on, you think to yourself, is it worth it? I mean, there is a price to pay when you're well known. And I've always felt there was a balance point. I have a lovely house and I have a super lifestyle, and I enjoy the work, but when the enjoyment is removed because of the pressure, and then you've got all this outside stuff going on. Helen and I talked about it. We really did talk about whether or not it was worth it, and whether or not I would miss doing live television. And the decision is, yes, I would.
Are you going to fling yourself back into it on Christmas morning?
Yeah, I'm really looking forward to that. It was a most appropriate thing, really, to say yes to. I mean, it would have been a positive decision to say no, if that doesn't sound too much like Double Dutch. It was a contracted thing, and also I've always, ever since the days of dear old Swap Shop, I've wanted to be on Saturday morning, Christmas Day morning, and doing a live show and being part of everybody's Christmas. And I'd also always wanted to do a show from the top of the telecom tower. And so the third year of it is sort of, if you can have a tradition in 3 years, you know, I mean, we've established a tradition.
Yeah.
And we've got some great things planned, marvellous things lined up. So I'm really looking forward to it.
Are you going to tone down your own personal flamboyant lifestyle now that the heliocopeters and the gay parties and all that kind of thing, for which you're well known and famous? Sorry, jolly parties.
I've never been like that at all.
No, come down, no.
About the party.
But the helicopters and all the flying and all that kind of stuff. Worry Helen at all?
Now that she's pregnant, yes, she's actually said that she feels very nervous. I understand it's part of pregnancy that a lot of women do find that they get nervous in cars and flying. But I've got a helicopter company now, and we have a lot of fun with that, and we fly a lot of famous people around. And
you provided all the helicopters for Live Aid, that great Live Aid.
We did. It was really that which proved to me that we could make a go of the company, because we had we were entrusted by Mr. Geldof and Mr. Goldsmith to move all these people into Wembley. We took over a London Transport cricket pitch to land all these superstars on, all of whom were brilliant, no prima donnas. Everyone turned up on time. But my lasting memory of Live Aid was that here were these £3 million helicopters flying in with mega millions of superstars in them and whatever, and there was a cricket match going on. We had to do this deal with London Transport whereby they continued with the game. So the moment a helicopter came in to let out David Bowie or whatever, they all rushed to one corner, and then out got the stars, because some of them, for various reasons, wanted the blade stopped so that bits of them didn't blow off. And then And then the game would go on, but sometimes the helicopter didn't have to go away until it had someone to take. So they brought a lot of fielders to stand in front so that a cricket ball didn't actually go through a window. And it was just so, well, you know, 100,000 people and billions of people around the world were having this magnificent occasion. Here were 22 Englishmen having a game of cricket. And it was just, it was so wonderful, really.
We wish you luck with the Christmas morning show.
Thank you.
Nice to see you back.
Thanks very much.
That's another one down the plug hole. I'll see you Friday with Pete and Cat Beale from Albert Square, Julie Walters, and our special Christmas showcase. So be here at 7. Good night.